Well, friends, this is our English class, and we are going to learn this very beautiful lesson. You know that our country, India, is a secular country. We see many people live in our country. Many religions are there, many castes are there, but they live in a great harmony. So, when we think about the people of India, what type of people or which type of people we get in our mind? Can you tell me that? Many people, many religious people live in India. For example, Muslim people are there, Hindus are there, Sikhs are there, Isais are there, and many more. Buddhists are there, Jains are there. So many religious people are living in India. And they are living in a great harmony. They have great brotherhood among everyone else. They have great friendship among each other. So that is what the unique feature of Indian people. So if we think about the history of India, that who has or who had rule over India, then we know that there are many, like Britishers have come, and you know that we got independence on 15th August 1947. So only Britishers were there? No. Many foreign people also were there in India. So in that, Portuguese, Dutch also were there. So those people have come in India and they have put some impact on us. We have taken their lifestyle. Now we are using car, coach and everything. Okay, this is the we have followed it by the Western people, Western countries people. So that is what, before that we were using dhoti, kurta, like that was our costume. But right now we are busy because we are matching to old world. So something we have taken, something we have adopted from Britishers, something we have adopted from Dutch people, something we have adopted from the Portuguese people. So there are some questions are given. So we are going to learn one lesson from your first fight. Okay, the glimpses of India. And in the glimpses of India, there are three lessons. And from that, we are going to learn. First, there is Baker from Goa. Baker. So when we heard the name Baker, we can understand it relates or it is belongs to bread and butter, bread, or you can say loaves of bread. You can understand. So Baker from, you can understand. So it's a painted portrait of Baker. Okay, you will see that. So who has written this letter? That you see a Baker from Goa by Lucio Rodriguez. So Lucio Rodriguez is the writer of the lesson. So suppose we think about, then we have to understand the character of the Rodriguez. He is a great Cockney essayist. He has written many essays, several articles. He has written in English also and Cockney also for periodicals and magazines. Then he has worked as a visiting professor. He has worked as a visiting professor. And if we see about his whole literature, he has greatly contributed in English literature. So once again, briefly we understand about Lucio Rodriguez. He is a great Cockney essayist. Then he has written several articles in English and Cockney for the periodicals and some magazines. He has worked as a visiting professor and he has given much contribution in field of literature. Okay, so at the beginning of the lesson, some questions are given. What image of people and places come to your mind when you think of our country? Already we have discussed that many kinds of people we see, many religious people also we see, and where they live according to that places we get many images in our mind. Then what part of country have you lived in or visited? So, when we have vacation, we go for the outing and we try to grab some things, we try to learn something from the different locations. Some locations attract us. Can you name some popular tourist destinations? So there are many tourist destinations which we like to visit, and surely you will ride different destinations in your own. You may know that apart from British, the Dutch and the French, the Portuguese have also played a part in the history of a country. And there are certain influence of those people, those kind of people, on our lives. Still we use it. Actually, our cuisines, we can say our food was chapati, bhaji, or some like rice also. But now in our daily food, beef, pizza, burger. So pizza, burgers are not from our Indian culture. We have adopted, we have taken it from the foreign culture, foreign culture. So like that, many things we have adopted, which we like, and that we have adopted. Similarly, they have also adopted like our bhakri, our thesa, many things they have also taken from our India. So this is what the, you know, some communication, some things which they like, they have taken. We like, we have taken. Okay, like that. Can you say which part of the India grew tea and coffee? That is the question based on your geography knowledge, and you have to answer it in your flowchart. So we'll go for the baker from India. This is the pen portrait of the traditional Goan village baker who still has an important place in his society. You might ask your forefather, like your grandfather or your father, that what you used to do when you were very small. So that time everything was not at the mall. Okay, so now there is a great era that we like to go in mall, we like to go in bazaar, where we go and we select some items which we like and we take, put it in our basket, and we at the end we use credit card or debit card for the payment, or your mother, father also there, and they pay the whatever money or whatever you have taken. But before that, when if you think about the past 50 years or 40 years, you understand that some people used to come. Right now you might have witnessed that during this COVID-19, we can't go outside to purchase some things. So some vegetable sellers come to your place, they sell some vegetables, liquid vegetables, some fruit vegetables, and we take it. Milk man also come to your house and they give us, or he gives us some bag of milk, or sometimes we get in the litter. So these things. But if we think about the past, some baker used to come to the house every day. I know that we have great habit to have bread with the tea, and tea is the great beverage of our India or Maharashtra. Whenever any guest comes, we offer them tea, coffee. But coffee we have taken from others, but tea is the usual, or usually we drink tea or we offer tea anymore. So before 40 years, up to 50 years if we think, then we can understand, if you ask your father or grandfather, that some bakers used to come to the house to give bread and butter. Butter means different kind of, not butter means which we have used like oil and all, not like that, but bread. Okay, they used to bring bread, and every day, there was not a single day on which we didn't see any baker who has come to sell bread. Okay, so like that. So in this particular story, a baker from Goa is a pen portrait of that particular baker. This baker community, you can say that how he used to come and how he used to make us happy, that matter wants to convey in this lesson. So we see the lesson. This is the pen portrait of a traditional Goan village baker who still has an important place in his society. So there are certain things which never be vanished in our life, from our life, or from the human civilization, because those things have put a great impact on the civilization. So like that baker also, still we haven't forgotten bread. We use bread for sandwiches, we use bread for some patties or many things, or we use our most very favorite, that is vada pav. We use that pav, bread. So this is the story of pen portrait of the baker of the village Goan. Our elders are often heard reminiscing nostalgically, fondly, very happily about those good old Portuguese days. And story about a Konkan, Miss Goa. And in Goa, at that period, Portuguese people used to live. Now also some people are living, there. But that time, there were many people living in Goa. And those were Portuguese days. The Portuguese and their famous loaves of bread, those eaters of loaves might have vanished, but the maker are still there. And now we are not eating that bread from the Portuguese. Those who have eaten, they might have gone. But still, the makers are there. It's not exactly those makers, those who have produced, but their son, their daughters might have there, and they might prepare the bread for us. We have still among the users, us, the mixer and molders and those who bake the loaves, that whatever instruments are there to make the bread are still there. Those age-old, time-tested furnaces still exist. And you know that bread must be properly baked in the furnace. That furnace is also there. The fire in the furnaces has not yet been extinguished. It's put off. Still, it is fire is there. Still, they are using that furnaces with the fire. The third and jingle of the traditional vehicle bamboo, Hiraji is what? Announcing his arrival in the morning can still be heard in some places. So if we go in some rural area, still some bakers are coming there. They just come and they distribute bread there. So how they come? They have certain certain sign of arrival. They use bamboo stick. They third jingle sound of the bamboo. Third and jingle is a falling sound music they create. It is a very unique sound. So we can understand that okay, the baker has come to give us loaf of bread. Okay. And in the morning they come twice in a day. That time they used to come twice in a day. In the morning can still be heard in some places. Maybe the father is not allowed, but the son still carries on the family profession. These bakers are even today known as Padar in Goa. They are called Padar in Goa. Not baker exactly, but they have got new name at a time. Still, the people from Goa call them Padar, P-A-B-E-R. Now, during our childhood in Goa, the baker used to be our friend. Why? Because the person who has gives us something which we like, and ultimately the particular person becomes our friend. And bakers was that person at that time who used to give us our lovely thing which we like most. That is sent to us. And that is why he was the friend of very many people of our many small kids also. And companion and guide us, he used to come at least twice a day. That was very fun because the thing which we like, suppose the person will come for twice, it will be, we will be overwhelmed for that. Once when he set out in the morning on his selling route, and then again when he returned after emptying his used basket, first he used to come to sell, and afterwards throughout the village he used to roam, and after selling all the product, whatever he has prepared, then again in the evening he used to go from there with the empty basket. So twice they used to see, people used to see them. The jingling third of his bamboo woke us up from sleep, and we ran to meet and greet him. And already I told you that when he used to come, that time he used to make very third and jingle sound, which was unique. And similarly, when we used to listen this particular voice or sound, we used to understand that this is the baker's sound, so he has come. And as soon as we used to hear that, we used to run at the bakers. We ran up to the to meet and greet him, and he used to work as the alarm clock. As soon as he used to make his noise, and we used to run at him. Why was it so? Was it for the load of Miss, for bread we were running there? Not at all. The loaves were bought by the pastime, the maids of the house, because we were never allowed to collect those loaves of bread. Then why we used to go there? It was for the loaves of bread. 6 that because of the elders, they couldn't gain that all, we couldn't collect that. That a maid servant used to go there and collect the bread and butter, bread from the baker. What we long for were those bread bangles. So, different product was there. The bread bangle was circular, figure. That was bread bangles which we chose carefully. Because, something we want to eat, that we have great interest in that, and then we choose it very carefully. Because I have to eat it, so I have to select very fine, which I like most. That I mean. So, for choosing the bread bangles, the small kids used to run at the baker. Sometimes it was very sweet bread of the spherical made. Okay. The baker made his physical entry on the scene with the chan chan sound of his specially made bamboo staff. And he used to make that. Okay. The particular bamboo he used to use to make that particular thing. One hand supported the basket on his head and the other banged the bamboo on the ground. He would greet the lady of the house with the good morning because he is from Portuguese, so he knows very well English. That is why he used to greet in English all the women of the house. He would greet the lady of the house with a good morning and then place his basket on the vertical bamboo. He used to make a stand of that particular bamboo. His wickets would be pushed aside with the mild rebuke and the loaf would be delivered to the servant. And obviously we were very small kids, that's why we used to rush towards that bamboo, that baker's, but rebuke is forcefully used to aside, keepers aside, and maid servant or servant used to collect the bread from the baker. But we would not give up, we would climb a bench or the parapet, okay, and peep into the basket somehow. Small kids are small kids, they never stop. Whatever they want to do, they do that. And that is why they used to peep in the basket through some other thing, benches and all. I can still recall the typical fragrance of those loaves. Okay, because this was the very great intention of the small kids to see that. That is why they have never forgotten. We never forgotten the fragrance of that bread. Both for the elders and the bankers of for the children. And there were particular category for the loaves or bread. Loaves for the adult people or some people of the member of the family, and bread bangers for the small kids. Then we did not even care to brush our teeth or wash our mouth properly, because once we want to eat something which is our favorite, then we forget everything, all hygiene and everything. That is what. Because when baker used to bring that bread, they forgot. They used to banish cleaning the mouth. Right? And so we, who would take the trouble of plucking the mango leaf for the toothbrush? If we see past time or past days, now we have different toothbrushes, toothpastes to brush our teeth. But if we study the past era, they used to use mango branches, very delicate mango branches or neem branches, okay, bitter lemon that branches to brush the teeth. Because at that time there was not Oral-B or Colgate Chicha or something like Pepsodent, nothing more than. So it was very troublesome. Now we wake up in the morning and we see that the stand of the brush, we take one of the medium, soft or hard brush and we use, put on that toothpaste on that and we try to brush our teeth. But it was not the same scenario in the past. These people have to go to the tree, they have to cut down, they have to break the very delicate branches of the tree, they have to root out or they have to pick out, pluck out the all the leaves, and then they have to eat. They have to brush it by the those mango branches. And why was it necessary at all? The tiger never brushed his teeth. Hot tea would wash and clean up everything through night. Very funnily, Vatel mentioned here. Tiger never crosses river, still his teeth are very, his teeth are very powerful. Tiger, so no need. So not brushing teeth is not that very harmful for us. Tiger can manage and he has great and very powerful teeth. Then why we should brush our teeth? It's a funny thing he has said. Now again he has said that marriage gifts are meaningless without the sweet bread known as the moon. And so bread has a very significant role or a significant value in everywhere. In marriages also there should be some bread, and it is called bone. This is a party or a feast loses its charm without bread. And suppose we are making a party or we are doing party, that time also bread is both the essential integral part of the party. Not enough can be said to show how important a baker can be for the village. So everywhere there should be bread, a slice of bread or loaves of bread. If not, then it is meaningless. So by this we can understand how the baker was very important for the village. The lady of the house must prepare sandwiches on the occasion of her daughter's engagement. Sandwiches should be made. So sandwiches is bread. Again, baker is very important here. Cake and polinas are a must for the Christmas as well as the other festivals. So whenever any festivals used to come on, any engagement or any marriage ceremony, that time breads were integral part of it. Thus, the presence of the baker's parents in the village is absolutely essential. So baker should be there and his parents should be there, then only people can get the bread. So the baker or bread seller of those days had a peculiar dress known as the kabahi. So there was a certain dress, which was very particular dress. Peculiar dress was there, and the name of that dress was kabahi, K-A-B-A-I, kabahi. It was a single piece long frock reaching down the knee. Single piece long frock reaching till the your knee or little down to the knee. In our childhood, we saw bakers wearing a shirt and a trouser which were shorter than full length once and longer than the half pants. Even though we can say that 3/4 we used to wear like that dress or costume was there of the baker. Even today, anyone who wears a half pant which is just below the knee is invited to comment that he is dressed like a baker. So now also in that particular Konkan villages in Goa, suppose somebody will use 3/4 or the half pant is more than knee, then they invite to comment, oh, you are looking like a baker because you have one similarly like a baker. So now we are at the last part of the lesson. The baker usually collected his bill at the end of the month. Then you can understand that how sober the person baker was. He was not ready about the money. At the end of the day, end of the month, he used to collect the bills. And till what the people used to do? They used to write on the walls. Okay, now we don't have khata book. Right now there is one app that is khata book. And we can put it there, so no need to buy hard or keep in mind. But that time, all things were not there. That is why they used to write on the wall by pencils. So monthly account used to be recorded on some wall in the pencil. Baking was indeed a profitable profession in the old days, because everyone used to purchase that. Because without bread, nothing was possible. That is why this profession was very, very profitable, because they used to get much money, much amount of money through this profession. That is why it was very, very popular and very professional profession. The baker and his family, they were starved. Now everybody gets food to eat. But before, suppose we think about the past era of our country, then you can understand many people had died because of starvation. But this was the one community, this was the baker who never starved, because he used to get enough money to fulfill his bill and his family also. So he and his family and his servants are very good, happy and prosperous, very healthy, very wealthy. Their plum physics was an open testimony of this. Plum means little strong, healthy, we can say public statement, okay, pleasant fat body. Okay, we can understand by the fat body, okay, you are from the very healthy and wealthy family. So like that, bakers were looking so little strong and little fleshy fat persons. Even today, any person with the jackfruit like physical appearance is very fat, obese, okay? Then it is easy compared to a beggar. So, this is what we are learning the lesson. A beggar from the Goa. In this particular lesson, writer Lucio Rodriguez have put focus on the beggar. It is the main portrait of the beggar of the Goan village. And beggar has great importance in the particular village. And without bread, nothing was possible. Basically, it is an engagement, it may be the marriage or any party or anything. Bread is very essential thing for that. So, still now there are many furnaces also there, and that the instrument which used to make bread. So, that was also there. And baker was used to play the role of the alarm clock. Because as soon as he uses third and jingle sound, small kids used to wake up and they rush towards the baker. And they used, they didn't never got that freedom or permission to collect whatever they but maid, servant used to collect. But they used to peek through that basket, what exactly is there. And they used to choose their bangles, bread bangles. And there was certain sorting out that bread were eaten by the old people and all adult people, and that bread bangles used to eat by the smaller. So there was great, and also we have seen that economic condition of baker, because bread was a very essential part of the life of the people of the Mongan village, and that is why they used to get much money from that. So their family never starved. Okay. So what exactly we have learned through this lesson, that some heritage of a country. Some people have come from the different country, but they have settled here and become our culture also. From our Mongan village, we have got, there are certain images also there. Right now, certain particular body language, particular costumes. And if someone will use that costume, then people used to say, you are like a beggar, you have wore like a beggar, you have worn like a beggar. So, this is what the glimpse of India. So, this is one type of glimpse we have seen here about the beggar. So, when we think about India, then India is a secular country, and we see that different kind of people, and they have put some impact on our lives. That's what we have learned in this lesson. So, I hope that you have understood the lesson very well, and I hope that you will write the flowchart of the lesson.